setting number 14, Kimberly Hill. Number 15 is through the outside. This is Halle lining up. Celia, the other outside hitter, number 17. And so Paula Igonu is in the opposite slot. Making decision action for the high five. Daniele Santarelli and his team were ecstatic after the semi-final victory. Same feeling, hopefully, for Mariano, the means won't be looking. Getting over the line. Time then for Itzasabashi to come out onto court. Boskovic, of course, is going to start in the opposite slot. Number three, Lauren Gibbermeyer is going through the middle. And it's a start for Beisa Arici through the middle. Kim Yong-kun, number 10, the captain, is through the outside. Natalia Herrera is the other outside hitter, and it's Carly Lloyd, number 13, who's setting. So no place on court for Yasmin Gubeli, number 8, who started the semi-final. She is moved to the bench. Marco Iraglio Mota from Brazil deciding that, actually, this is the team that can get the job done. Simgi starting in Libero, number 5. The players are on court, the referees have been introduced, the players have been introduced, they are ready to play. The crowds are very much ready for this one to get underway. And for those of you watching around the world, get yourselves comfy as best you can, as this is about to get going here in Shaoxing. Time. It's Asabashi, Vitra Istanbul of Turkey in the orange and black serving Imoko volley. Conegliaro of Italy receiving in blue. This is the gold medal match from the FIVB Women's World Club Championship here in Shaoxing, China. That's a good dig from De Janeiro. Celia looking to get the side out, and the first point not happening just yet. Down ball coming from Kim, another chance here for Conegliaro. And it's Foley through the middle, and side out achieved by the Italian side. Don't want to get too excited just yet, it's only the first point. We're watching this one for a couple of hours. If we go to five sets, could be two and a half. Back to old school volleyball. And it was score from serve to first to 15, and matches regularly went to 2.5 hours plus. Foley again through the middle, two in a row for her. And it's 2-0 for Conegliaro. What a not happy. Really good start this for Foley, because she has established herself very quickly. Gibbermeyer has got work to do now against Foley, and that's going to Gibbermeyer pinned in the middle and allow Walsh to move the ball wide for Conegliaro and hopefully create some gaps in the block. Lloyd goes behind to Gibbermeyer, but she's slowed down by a decent block from Conegliaro. Simge, good dig by Simge. Good dig by De Janeiro. Hill's on the chase. It'll be free ball back for Itzasabashi here. Four players ready to go and have an attack, and it's Boskovic with her first big swing, but Kim's onto it. Unfortunately, it's too close to the advertising hoarding, and quite rightly, Paolo Igonu deciding that her safety is more important than chasing after the ball in the first 3 points of the match. Lloyd with the serve. Decent enough ball in the middle, can be run. Kim does well to get onto it, so does Natalia. Free ball now for Conegliaro. Four attacking options. Foley again through the middle. 3 points for Foley now. Well, this is a really good tactic from Vojvodina, because there's no doubt Itzasabashi have been watching the tape, watching what Corneliano do. So have Corneliano for Itzebashi. And there's a definite change in tactics here for Corneliano. Transition. That's a good block from Gibermeyer and Natalia. Itzebashi to within a point. Always difficult when that ball is low, a little bit inside. Sometimes as well, it's tight to the net and your ability to do anything with it is very limited. Natalia with the serve for Itzebashi. Excellent ball in. Oh yes, and that's why having Foley go through the middle three times in a row is so important, because suddenly Paolo Conti's got a one-on-one and almost, and as good as a fact, a one-on-no-one as she batters that ball away. That work that Foley's done through the middle is now already paying dividends with the gaps that are going to appear potentially in Itzebashi's wide blocks. Nice work by Kim. Bionu and Hill and Cilia are going to be, and also that Borosh are going to be responsible for lining up the blocks for Corneliano in making sure that the middles can get out and close in, and also then not leave any gaps, not go too wide, so that the cross court becomes open when the middle joins up with the cross court with the wing blockers. De Graaf's in on the action, so both middles established already. Bogu watching on. The other middle for Corneliano. And if Corneliano keep playing that way, this doesn't look like Bogu's going to get on court, does it? De Graaf will finally play well. Big serve from Igonu. Natalia is pretzelled. She's twisted and turned by that serve. And the ball goes into the crowd. Gono was interviewed post-match after the thrilling semi-final win. The 21-year-old just said, don't care who we play in the final, we're just going to go out and look to get the win. That's not touched the block from Boskovic. Bit of a shaky start, this, from Itzebashi. So they're going to challenge just to be sure, because 7-3 is a four-point difference, as opposed to 6-4, which would be 2. So it's quite a big shift potentially here if this ball has caught the block of Corneliano from the swing by Boskovic. It's got to be close, must be close, for the decision not to have come just yet. I'll tell you what, not the best angle for us to be watching, because the ball covers the hand, and we're seeing that pretty slowly, but ball quite happy and caught the fingers. There's no complaints, he'll notice it caught her. Yeah, did catch me. So 6-4. Only 2 points in it now. Boskovic with the serve. She could very well get the team back to within one. But that is a wonderful pass under the circumstances. And it's a net touch against Itzebashi. What a really good ball that is, was from Cilia. Ball in again for Borosh. Over the top, good up by Kim. Natalia works the line. Itzebashi working the score in their favour as they get back to within one. Free ball here for Izasabashi. They could be level. Unfortunately, Kim just getting her timing wrong and her angles wrong. So we'll go to the technical timeout. It's Corneliano leading by two. Tricky for Igano. It looked innocuous enough, but there wasn't a top spin on this one. It's got a horrible side spin on it, and that's what Igano didn't pick up on. Top ball in again from Cilic. Seven, very good game at the moment. And then Igano with a warm-up swing, really. Golf clap from Seth Berlini, seen it here before. This is the expectation. He's actually gone over the top of Natalia. Borsch with the serve. Big front row this now for Corneliano. A serve from Borsch. The front row with Silla and Foley. Good touch. Silla wanted a quicker ball, a little instinctively from her, had to check. Borsch somehow just about keeps it in play. Now Igano. Better opportunity here. There's more options. Hill, brick swing from Hill on the pipe. Well, the big, however you are used to having it described to you, and play. Quick, that's pretty much what it was. Squeezing past Gibbermeyer and onto the floor. Timeout and assassination. Swing from Boskovic. It's not been the best for her. Her last point came with the courtesy of a micro touch from Hill. That one was a little bit too far in front. She's chasing after it. Not caught the block. And if Boskovic isn't playing well, that's huge for Corneliano, because she really is dangerous as an opposite. Gets another go, and again, but you know what, Boskovic wasn't even expecting that one. She never looked like she thought she was going to get it. There was no real intent about her run-up, but to be fair, it wasn't the best ball. She's been walked quite a lot inside. this for Corneliano. Six ahead. Those of you supporting them won't be counting the chickens just yet, though. That'll stay in play. Is that Sebastian? You have to try once more. And so on the second time of asking, they get the point. And that is the important point from Corneliano's perspective, is Natalia had to have two bites of the cherry, which means Corneliano doing really well at getting touches, slowing the ball down, making the court seem very small, and not giving Itzasabashi the opportunity to hit clean winners. And over time, that will have an effect. Excellent. That work that Bolos did right at the start of this set to bring Foley in. It's now got Gibbermeyer and Co. jumping like puppets on a string with Foley, who's now not getting the ball. It's opening up the court for Corneliano to hit the ball into. More trouble here for Itzasabashi. Into transition, break point chance. Hill batters it off the block. Well done, Simgi. Free ball for a very hesitant Itzasabashi. Foley again draws Gibbermeyer and gives Hill the one-on-one. And Corneliano leading 15-8. Tactically, very, very, very good from Corneliano at the moment. Oh dear, there's an issue. This apple's been batted off of Natalia's finger. She's feeling that. The tape isn't just for show. No, the referee's got to make a decision as to whether or not you make a substitution. Natalia, you'll have to be substituted. You need to receive some treatment. It's nothing too bad. Last thing you want is any kind of dislocation or any break. If it's a break, that's going to be really bad. Is it a little bit of a dislocation or just a tweak that can be taped back? Be a bit of a rippage of the nail. Oh, yeah, do you know what? She's just, you can see she's gone to play that and put a hand to it. And, oh, those of you that have had that happen, you know exactly what she's going through. Might just be a bit of a nail. Which is good, that's fine. She's going to play on, which is great. It's great for Itzasabashi, it's great for Spitris. It's great for Corneliano at the moment. Silvia with the serve, 15-8. Big, big lead. Which has just got bigger as Boskovic has been blocked by Foley. Go to the technical timeout, 16-8. What a lead. Itzasabashi and Carly Lloyd in particular here has got to find a way to try and get Boskovic back into this one and make her a threat. And Corneliano have got to keep doing what they're doing and try and make Boskovic not a threat. And the way they've done that is with this really good serving that's getting Itzasabashi in positions where they really don't want to be, and then the balls that Boskovic has been getting have been horrible. It's another point that Itzasabashi get, but another one that they've had to scrap for. Not a clean winner again. Some good defense from Silja, just a little bit tight, so a good block from Boskovic. Natalia with the serve. Great ball from Silja. First error from Carlo Gonu. There won't be any panic just yet. metres and 44. So that's exactly 1 metre above the height of the net. Biedermeier above the height of the net to make sure that one didn't come back. This is poor pass, first one of the match. Just a couple. Santirini let it slide for the moment. Won't call timeout just yet. He might do if they lose this point. Emiliano, if they side out there, all will be forgotten. Back on track. Keep moving forward. That's a tough one. What are we going to call a timeout here? It's a little bit unlucky though, because that ball's clipped the net. Just dropped to call the energy at it. Foley did well because De Janeiro was never going to get to it. Indeed, timeout called. That is the kind of the mental tightrope I was talking about at the start of the program. That teams, players walk hugely, everything's fine, they're up, it's comfortable. And then suddenly a little run of points from the other team, and it's like, ooh. But not in that kind of panic way, just in that the way that your mind works generally. That normal, healthy sense of paranoia that we all have can kick in these situations. Just don't want to let that happen. So a little timeout, couple things down, try and take a sting out of Natalia's refocus, regroup, and look for the side out. Tasabashi looking to continue on this serving run. It's not going to happen though for Emiliano. Paolo Ogona thinks that there is a touch of the block, so we're going to have a challenge. Is there a touch? We've had a lot of players have said definitely a touch. And then the screen's shown there wasn't one. And the surprised looks that we've seen this week have been quite extraordinary at times. But another surprise look coming as well. It hasn't touched anybody. Cilia's gone off, Gertie's has come in, and that's because Cilia's been targeted. She's gone from being brilliant, probably almost a 2-9 pass stat, probably somewhere down to 2-3 with those balls that were putting the team out of system. So she's out, Gertie's in, and that's a nice ball. And the ship is steadied, the leaks have been plugged. And Eliano have the ball and a 4-point lead. Smiles return to the team, possibly to the fans as well. Foley. In the block, so it's up to the blocking team to challenge that. No challenge coming because they know they touched it. Really good refereeing. And Zasabashi take the point. The referee, whilst you're watching that ball, clearly stated touch during the rally. Zasabashi get their side out, but again, it's really scrappy volleyball from Zasabashi. They're having a couple of goes every time to get their side out, which just shows the kind of pressure that Corneliano are bringing. Oh, yes! Dare say it, at times, Paolo Ogona looks like she's jumping up above a badminton height there. Look at that! It's ridiculous. Ridiculously good. Paolo Ogona now with the jump serve. Good pass from Kim. Comes inside. Glides past the block. Gets the first real clean side out for Tasabashi in this set so far. Bolosh with her running spikes on gets that one up. It's also been brought up by Zasabashi. Kim gets the block out. It's a great point for Zasabashi, so they're back to within a couple. Have Zasabashi found their rhythm there? Important point for Corneliano getting the next side out. Boskovic. She was looking for a spark to get herself going, and a jump serve may be the thing that's doing it, because it's now been backed up in a brilliant block by Carly Loy. Helped out by Beza. Sinclair saying, get that ball higher. And it was high enough, but Lloyd arriving fashionably late to block her international compatriot. One in it. Boskovic with the serve. It's an ace serve from Boskovic. We're all square. It's game on now in this first set. Pitti stays on court. Boskovic licensed to really go after this one, which she does, and it's a clean ace from Boskovic. She's beaten Hill, all ends up. Boskovic has woken up. She's ready to play. That's an exceptionally good serve. Timeout. Corneliano trailing for the first time in this set.
Ball inside the court, and then if we play high ball, don't close your shot. But okay, let's go, girl.
Well, the wheels haven't come off for Corneliano. This rotation, get back to the mindset they had at the start of this one. We might see Foley engaged a little bit more through the middle. Hopefully that's not going to be the end. We saw those 3 points in a row from her. Good ball from Gerties. Hill is slowed down by the block. Oh yes, that's a great angle from Kim. Giuliano can't get off this rotation. Again, what a serving run she's having. Oh, what a dig by Simge. And then Boskovic, who's now fired up, gets the ball down. Well, we're going to look for a ball up, ball down. Pancake. Is the universal call. Was it a pancake or was it fake news? Oh, pancake. There's nothing wrong with the footfall, so when I say pancake, then looking at it, I didn't see any pancakes anyway. Looking at to see whether it was a footfall. Turnaround this has been for Zasabashi. Corneliano as comfortable as you could get in a first set gold medal match. Celia has some work to do here. Boskovic has turned things around for her team. And eventually the run comes to an end. Now 21-19 is the point at which for Zasabashi, this is by no means a done deal. So many times 21 is the number that you see that kind of determines that that team will take the set. But at 21-19, that is by no means guaranteed. Especially as Hill's got that into transition. Ngannou on the inside 10 brings it back to 20-21. A break point right off the bat for Corneliano after getting the ball back. Follow inside, hits the ball back outside. There's a chance for De Janeiro. by her very high standards, she knows that was a missed opportunity to make a dig. But being the world-class player she is, she's not going to let it bother her. She'll make a mental note and say, right, OK, one step to the right. Zasabashi's blocking's doing very well in the latter part of this set, slowing the ball down. That was good work from Panigliano. The gun is really close to that 3 metre line. There's going to be a challenge coming from Motta. He was looking at it straight away. Just how close was Igano? Is it a point for Panigliano, or is it going to go the way of Zasabashi? Got himself a yellow card in the last game in the semi-final for trying to tell the referee how to do her job. Ooh, semi-one just behind. Surely that's behind, isn't it? No fault it is. It's a horrible picture to see. It's so blocky. Well, this is where Motta just needs to be quiet, because the referee's calling the captain out and saying, look, I know the big screen's horrible and it's blocky and it's not great, but on the big screen that, and on the screen that Hawkeye have, it's a brilliantly perfect HD picture. That Santarelli's being told off. He looks like butter wouldn't melt in his mouth, doesn't he? We're going to have a substitution. Sorokite coming in. Okay. Work from the referee to tell the captains, go and tell the coaches, calm it down. Kim telling the coach, oi, calm down, coach. Sorokite comes in then, serving duty for her. Jump serve. Zasabashi. Sorry, Kate, not really contacting that one high enough. But you can have no excuses. If you're a player that you know is going to be coming in for those situations at some point in the match, particularly probably around that time, you've got to make sure you stay warm, you're moving, you are ready, and you're up to game speed. You can't just expect to walk off the bench after 20 minutes and doing nothing but stood there and think it's all going to be fine. Nice work by Igonu. Panigliano still need a break point to get level. I think they've just got it. They have done. Quick touch the challenge. Boskovic thinks it was in. That's why it's really important. The development of the game, as you see it and we watch it, is Boskovic hits that point, she's gone in to celebrate, she's not looking at anything else, and that's a couple of seconds, 3 or 4 seconds have gone. And look at that, that smiles in, it's a brilliant swim. But potentially could have lost the challenge for that. Because of this need that teams have now to celebrate every single point, whether they win or lose. Those of you that have played the game, maybe don't play anymore, but played back maybe in the 80s, 90s, that happens. Might have a little slap of the hand and just got on with the next point. Game changes in many different ways. For the majority, for the better. For Zasabashi, this set has just turned on his heel for the better. They take it from under the noses of Panigliano. What a turnaround for Zasabashi. We were trailing by some margin in the first set. But it's Boskovic gets it off of Foley. So it's actually lead by 1-0 here in Chelsea. Boskovic with the ball in hand from the serving line suddenly found her rhythm. She found a way to get back into the match and became a real threat as a result of that. Now both teams fully up to game speed, warmed up, ready, with their eyes in. It's Asabashiyu who have made the first statement of intent. Kamiliano now need to respond. Second set underway. Gonu with a massive serve, which puts Zasabashi out of system. And that's a good dig. Oh, that's a good dig as well. Well played by Kim. Oh, it's got a little bit fractured. And then Natalia finds a ridiculously good angle. On the pipe, good up, De Janeiro. Celia likes to try and knock doors down with her spiking, is the best way to describe it, really. She, you look at some of the other players, look at Kim, Natalia, and you look at Hill, and they'll come up and look like they've got the ability to play some shots to turn the ground. Celia just goes up and hits bang. Pretty much in the way she's facing. I don't see her that often come up with the shots, but forgive me because I don't really get to see as much of her playing as perhaps I would like to, and a lot of us do. We only tend to see them, see the players when they're playing national team, when they're not being in the country in which they play a domestic volleyball. Such an athlete, that's the ball from so high. Away with it, but what Zasabashi are doing really well against Celia is they're making their block account later, so they're not trying to go up at the same time as Celia because she's just going to the top of them, but they're delaying it a little bit as Lloyd's been doing with Hill, and they're getting into the zone at the right time they need to be. Natalia was going on a line to cross net, that Caneliano's block was nowhere near. Got to take away the impact point when you're blocking. Well played by Borosh, hands are up. And Kim not keying in on her, not making that connection that she's the front court centre, so she's the first point of attack. Kim's gone out to try and stop a slide behind. Thinking about what might come instead of dealing with what was coming. Like she hits down onto the block at times. There is an absolutely amazing photo of her in action taken by Connie Kurth, the FIVB's official photographer out here in Shaoxing. It's taken from the roof looking down, and you just see the way that Igonu is opening up to hit the ball, and you can really sense the grace and the speed and the power that she can put into it in what looks like a really relaxed pose as well, in the air, ready to strike. We have haven't seen it, go on to the FIVB World Club Championship website. You can see it on there. You can also see it on social media. Hashtag FIVB Women CWC. Still, there's Asabashia finding ways through on the angles at the moment, wide, because Caneliano's block's going too wide and they're opening up the cross court. They need to try and sort that out, just bring their wing blockers in a little bit, put the left hand to the head of the spiker and say, right, if you want to go line, you're going to end up going straight into my forearm. If you're going to go cross court, we're going to shut that down as well. Just like that, that's not out. That was well in. Really good block from Kimberly Hill. Off that forearm, straight down. Sometimes doesn't translate well when you're watching on a screen to how hard the ball is being hit, but when I'm and you're sat there at home or wherever you're watching and you're going, whoa, you know that it's translated well. That was a massive hit from Igonu. I was looking at the monitor as well. Exactly the same thing. Kilometres an hour. It's just incredible. This is such a violent sport. Sometimes it just gets lost. How fun that it actually is. The physicality of it. Sending a projectile at each other. Short of 100 kilometres an hour. What's not violent about that? Celia. That's Igonu. Anyone else would have volleyed that in for a transition play. But not Igonu. Not much he can do there. Caneliano, just as they did in the first set, getting a nice early lead. This is the one that they have to keep hold of now. They want to level things up. That was too easily read. Well played by Folley to make a good touch. Igonu, brilliant. Looked like a one-step run-up. Quite rightly, Santarelli applauding that one. She's gone over the block and deep into the corner of one. There's no chance of anyone getting this. It's just a standing jump. Over the top, onto the baseline. Brilliant. Changes for Zasabashi. On comes number 11, Kelsey Alkelekic. Timeout called by Zasabashi. Mariano in a great position now. Six in front. Threats beginning to open up for Zasabashi around the court. They know they can do that. We've got Kim, we've got Tanik, can all hit the pipe. Caneliano were aware of it. They almost were able to shut that one out. Kim now with the serve. No chance for Igonu to go after that one. So you're not taking enough of a step to her right. So she's going to take a little step to her left. like a rabbit in the headlights at times, Gerties, but that's the way she is normally. Very, very good player. You have to be, if you want to play for Conegliano, you want to play in one of the best leagues in the world of volleyball. Chases on, Gerties should get that, does get that, well played. Yes! Yes, yes, yes. Ngannou coming up with the impossible and making it possible. Just like another day in the training gym. It's a good chase for Gerties, but look at the ball that she gets, that Ngannou gets here from De Janeiro. And then does that with it. Very quick call from the referee, who saw that the ball was on the side of Conegliano. Gams has gone up to play it. He's brought it back from the side of Conegliano. And that's not allowed. Actually, no, you can see he's not happy because it didn't look like it was from that replay. What a kidder she is. In the middle is held, Kim just over the top, and this is the result. Gibemeier again stuck, and he can't get there. Free swing, Ngannou with the jump serve. Backcourt setter, and as soon as the ball was touched by her above the height of the net and it went over, it's a fault, an attacking fault. For those of you wondering why she was called for that. She had to have left it alone. She's trying to get it to her middle block. A good lead by Kim, but it's gone in. Not such a good lead. Great serve, Ngannou. Two in a row for her now. And a big lead building up, which gives Ngannou license to rip into this one. Kind of working threes on jump serving. Find your rhythm with the first one. By the time you're on your third one, it's full blast, which is what that one was. Natalia off the net. Natalia in trouble. It's Asabashi in trouble here. Into the second technical timeout. Conegliano with a massive lead. Decent ball in from Kim and the circumstances, but pretty much a free ball here for Conegliano. Kim jumped a little early, didn't really get herself in a good position to have that swing because she was slightly ahead of the ball. Really wasn't able to go, so really nice block. Double substitution has been reversed. Boskovic back in. Lloyd back in. Akifak looking to get back in to this this Asabashi. Akifak played earlier against Navarra in the bronze medal match. Boskovic, Gerties, and Ngannou on the same shoulder line. And when you get on the same shoulder line, defending, it can cause problems. That's why, in fact, actually wasn't too bad, it was alright. Almost worked, they've gone just in front of Gertie, so ideally what you want. Gertie's almost kept it in play. Gono's a little bit too close to her. Gono come on that inside 10. Ball's hit the floor. That volley's not allowed. Another good serve that brings Lloyd off the net, so can't use the middle. And then a really well-formed, disciplined block by De Graaf and Bowash, which left Boskovic with nowhere to go. Ten points in front, dare I say it. Emiliano are going to win this set. For Ngannou is because as the ball hit the block, she was taking a step backwards instead of taking a movement downwards, being in a neutral position where you can go down and then from that downward position you can move forwards. She actually was going the wrong way. Nice work, those slight behinds, if they're not done very quickly, carefully be in trouble. Such a precise skill to run there between the setter and the spiker. Santarelli's going to have a little look here, wants to know whether or not Kim touched the net. Ball Corneliano. Well played, Ngannou. Chase is on. A really awkward one for Natalia. Did very well to change her body position and go running after it. Corneliano's got this set now. I'm prepared to put at least a euro on it. Natalia comes up with a really good swing. She's got the block right in front of her. The angles to go left and right aren't that great, but she finds a very good one. Gibbelmeier with the serve. Canediano needing 4 points to level the matchup. Worried with that if they look at it from the point of view of the fact that Bolos went to Foley and the middle block jumped with her, so that's a good sign. Sometimes volleyball is very much really a physical game of chess. If you sacrifice a few pawns in the form of going to the middle, it can prove very successful later on in the set. Bolos makes a good block. To a strong rotation here for Corneliano. Gertes, Foley, Egonu in the front row. Foley able to stop. There's how she goes through the middle. Good up by Vosch. Good up by Carly Lloyd. Oh, good pick up by Gertes. That was a huge swing from Boskovic. This rally really has just come to life. No, what a dig by De Janeiro. Is Asabashi still in the rally? Oh, good up again! Oh, what a shame. Brilliant, brilliant stuff. That's a quick thinking from Carly Lloyd. Comes up with the point for Asabashi. That's a really good chase from Carly Lloyd. Well watched by Kim, and then very quick thinking. De Janeiro very nearly kept it in play. Gertes went with the wrong arm. Set point now for Corneliano. And they're going to have an opportunity to get it done. First time of asking, but second swing. Through the middle, oh, that was lovely, a C quick. De Crouw puts it on the floor. Corneliano take the set, 25-14. It's one all here now in Shaoxing. Thank you. It's even Stevens now then between the two teams. Corneliano have to put to the back of their minds the loss of that first set after being up by so many, and they did that really well in the way they went about a near enough demolition of Itzasabashi in the second set. Now Itzasabashi know this game, they know they've got some work to do. This is the attack zone here from Itzasabashi, and it's been mostly out to Boskovic. Iroko in set two didn't run the middle once. Well, that's a big fat fibber dimmer. Liar, liar, pants on fire, isn't it? Because they ran the sequin. So it's that sequin right there between the left and right exposes the zones. That's the right middle. They ran a few slides as well because the zones in which they attack the ball, spreading it wide. And because of the movement of the middle of Foley and Dimitrov, they were able to open up those opportunities out wide on the wings. It was all stemmed really from that first set. Foley, maybe picked three in a row. Bang, bang, bang. It's Sebastian. Like, what is going on here? Has set the tone. Borwash may well go to the middle a couple more times. Start of this one. Again, just hammering home the point that we're a threat through the middle. You have to respect us. And that just delays. Give them the delays. Baser in getting out to where the real threat's going to come from, potentially. We'll see how it pans out as we get this third set underway. One all between Itzasabashi and Corneliano. Gertes keeps a place on court for Corneliano after coming in for Silja. That's all they've written in terms of the changes. No one else has come on or gone off. It's the same starting Itzasabashi team. And that's a good play from Bowa. She has gone to Foley, or to De Krauf. They've gone in now with the serve. Lovely touch. Good movement from De Krauf. Again, holding Beza and allowing Hill the cross-court angle. As Beza can't get out there quickly enough because she's had to wait and respect that De Krauf's a threat. See that movement? Never going to get out wide in time. Boskovic looking for a touch. She's got it. Well played by Hill. What a one and a carry on the set. He's not going to get it. Santorelli, he's just, that's lovely. Yes, well done, well done. Very good. His best English accent, obviously. Brilliant from Ngannou. It was indeed brilliant from Ngannou. Once again, has that movement backwards, doesn't she, when the ball is coming over? Just wonder whether or not Brion's probably going to do that, because now she's just, that's an easy ball to get in the circumstances if you take the neutral and move forward. How much technical do players get at this level now? Do they get any? I'm not. I just have to laugh at that. Just incredible performance. It's Lost for words, lost for words. Look at that, brilliant. Logano is bouncing the ball at will. Good up. That time staying in close. We'll get out now. This has to come over. Rather kindly for Beza. So Sabashi winning the scrappy points at the moment. Because the ball was a little bit high, Kiramaya had to wait just a little bit. Couldn't have a full swing. Chimero cut it already. Could be suggesting Kiramaya's going to make a cross-court block. It's interesting that you're already deciding where you're going to block when actually you've got to make your block, surely, based on what are the approaches of the opposite team. First, nicely done by Hill. Into the technical timeout. Liliano leading by three. Giramaya's getting into the action for Exasabashi right now. But that's because Corneliano's serving is not causing Exasabashi's serve-receive unit as much problem, as many problems as it has been. So they're able to put the ball in, and that means Lloyd's got options to put pressure on Corneliano's block. Good work, Foley back in, re-establishing. Team are doing and enjoying seeing themselves on the big screen as well. Good up from Hill. What a touch! What a shame it didn't come back over. Top swing from Boskovic. From Kibbermeyer saw the hand up straight, and every instinct told her it's a tip. And every instinct said it would be sure, because that's what tips are, aren't they? No, they're not. Hand up straight just means no hard hit. Kibbermeyer thinking about what was going to come instead of reacting to what came. Work by Gerties. Italia puts it in a good place for Exacerbashi to look for the point, but it's free ball now for Conegliano. Foley slides inside, 10 was also on the cards, but it's Di Krap actually on the slide, my apologies, who comes up with the point. Potter thinks it's been given as a carry. Interesting. Ball staying in the hand too long for Di Krap. Difference between that and any second ball the setter throws over. No card for the protestations. That means anyone now gets into trouble with the referee. Of character once again for Conegliano, for the individuals. Can they keep Exacerbashi at bay? Fortunately for Conegliano, Boskovic didn't get her timing right, had to adjust. Conegliano's block comes good. Nice play by Gerties. Sensible stuff from Igonu. Exacerbashi come again. And again. But now it's Conegliano who can have a go. And have a go they do, as Igonu bounces that one down into the corner. That's how you hit a volleyball.
Thank you.
very nearly from Gerties. But nearly's not good enough, not at this level. Natalia will take the point. Tatsubashi breathing down the neck of Corneliano here. Boskovic, that's looked like a big foot fault from Boskovic. And the referee has seen it. Commitment from middle block. It could quite easily have gone. Oh, do you know what? I'm not going to make it. But backed herself to get out there and made the block. She got a forehand on it, but made the block nonetheless. Bolwash. Am I forced to play it? Natalia gets it. Both Natalia and Kim are just world-class swing hitters. And also able to open up those cross-court angles against two blockers to put the ball on the floor. Gamsi comes in. And it's an opportunity for her to try and turn things around for her team. Stitching off the ball. We go to the second technical timeout. Corneliano leading by three. That's a really good serve. And off the back of a technical timeout, puts enormous pressure now on Tatsubashi as we head towards the business end, the last third of this third set. The race to 8 has been and gone, the race to 16 has been and gone. It's now the race to 25. And Corneliano are showing a clean pair of heels here to Tatsubashi. Went for a bird.
Lisa!
was. She was really tight to the net, but had good balance, good strength. Oh, in fact, it's Gamsi, even better, able to get that ball out wide. It's caught one side, line the other. In terms of what Gilmour wants to block, Donoghue though rattles it off the hands of the block. Eliano. Cassino once again comes on in this match to serve and play defence. That would have been something, wouldn't it? Cassino could have kicked that one back over. Reminiscent of Fabi 2012 Olympic Games. Lovely from Kimberly Hill. That time was in a really good rhythm with Borsch, with the ball, and able to hit that within her rhythm. Very nice flow to that play. Such a good flow for that one for Zasabashi. Kim doesn't find the court. Will a substitution. Go off, and they're coming in. Get the feeling. Motta knows this set's gone. Taking Lloyd off, taking Kim off. He's resting them for the next set. It's come off of the forearm of Ngannou. It's a complete miss hit. To business, delighting the fans and putting Corneliano within three of a 2-1 lead. As Asabashi, want to know whether or not Paolo Ngannou took off from behind the 3 metre line. Miles behind him. That was a long jump. Maybe going back and looking at that technique and say, right, you've got to get even more, get even closer. Mariana will come again. Gertie's again. It's a little bit too high for her, so advantage back here to Zasabashi, but Mendes ripped that one into the antenna. More changes as Botta takes the first six off, knowing the set's gone. Classic substitutions being made by Motta. See it an awful lot in these situations. Boskovic has a token swing, which really is all he needs in this instance for a side out. Mariano just need two side outs to wrap up the set, wander around the other side to De Janeiro. Oh, that should have been free ball. Any other person, it would have been free ball. And now Corneliano can have a go again. Incredibly, Ngolo has overcut it. Cut it past the line. Santorelli just pleased with the way that rally panned out. He'll be forever positive with his team where he can. Ngolo berating himself. A good lead by Gerties. It's now set point for Conegliano. Solakate's going to come in to jump serve. Been on once already. Didn't pan out too well for her as the net thwarted her ambitions. Tip by Boskovic to save the first set point. Straight through the middle goes Foley. Conegliano take the set, 25-19, they lead. It's Asabashi by 2-1 here, Xiaoxing in this gold medal match. Time for you to go and put the espresso machine back on, maybe put the champagne on ice, get it ready, who knows, refill the crisp bowl. Ready for set number 3-1, in which Conegliano will want to win one, but Itasabashi have to win. Itasabashi taking that first set, but look at that, it's been all Conegliano, 14-19. Fourth set underway, first point to Itasabashi. Conegliano leading by 2-1 in this gold medal match. The FIVB Women's World Club Championship. Gerties, who has claimed her place on court ahead of Celia, who was substituted out for her poor performance in passing, more than anything else, really. Gerties has come in and done a really good job, the German international. It's a real confidence booster for Yasmin Gabelli, who has started a few matches but didn't start this one, and neither did the setter either, Gamzee, but she's staying on for this set. Motta throwing a little bit of caution to the wind here. Yeah. Big server, big hitter, big blocker. Not quite such a big defender. It's a lovely ball in from Gerties. Challenge coming, in rally challenge maybe, the whistle hasn't gone. Doesn't matter, they get it down now. Players all thought the ball was down, but then they need to turn to the coach and say to the coach, you need to press for challenge. You can challenge in rally for various things you're allowed to challenge for, which is ball up, ball down, net touch, which would be the only two really you'd challenge for in rally, isn't it? Ball catching the antenna. Foot fault as well. I'll get there in the end. Good up. Better dig from Igonu. Out of the play though, but Hill isn't. Wow, what a pick up by Boskovic. Angle just ran away from Natalia. By Kim. Roll shot from Boskovic. Chance here for Corneliano. Hill, good up. Really good dig. Boskovic goes even harder at it and gets the block out. Really a big block point for Corneliano. Transition, so good, so difficult to deal with when you can do that. Gerties with the serve. Nice pick up by De Janeiro. And he's still going. Still, Mzasabashi can't find a way through. When they do, it gets dug. Hill, bit of work to do for her. Oh dear, Natalia's just snatched that away. But Boskovic is able to tidy up. That looked like it might have been heading back. Corneliano's way with a chance to have a swing. So that's about you take the points. All square. We're going to be going into the technical timeout after this point. Just separating the two teams. Technical timeout. Good pick up by Fully. Good pick up by Natalia. Great block by De Krauw. Lovely ball in the middle's run, and that's the best antidote to a big jump serve, is to be able to run the middle. Zasabashi. Mariano still in front though. So carry has been called against Gertz for playing that. That's a tough one. Doing that brilliantly, just picking the right notes at the right time. blast. That was a blast from Natalia. Me, everyone's looking at that. I thought she did it out for a minute. I honestly did think that she had Ighodo added that out, but it came down so quickly in the last meter. Did it come down enough? Yes. It came down enough, and that is kilometers in. Santarelli was convinced he was in. I just thought it was actually towards the baseline more. First view. Quick swing from Natalia that time, changed her rhythm. Once again from Ighodo, both her and Boskovic, the big guns for their respective club sides, and both have been putting on a great performance, but it's Ighodo who's leading the way. Good chance here. Hill doesn't really get out far enough, doesn't matter, Ighodo has a swing. Try and double up on Kim. Good touch by Gerties. Free ball now, though, for Itasubashi. Three front court options. The pipe's available. Kim with it. Good dig, Gerties, once again. Tried to go quickly to Hill. Didn't quite work. Ighodo high, wide, off the block, out of play. And Corigliano take the point. That's a big, big point to win in the context of this set and this match. Took it. Nice ball from Natalia. Excellent blocking by Hill and by Foley to slow it down, but they couldn't get in a good position to have a swing themselves, and it's Kim who rattles it off of the block. Jump float serve from Foley. Puts Natalia under pressure, takes her out of the attack, but it's Boskovic who's able to win the point with a good swing off the block. Boskovic hasn't really had that many clear winners, has she, in comparison to Igonu. It's just the way the game has gone. It's just the way that the teams have been able to deal with each other. Nice cover from Gerties. That's a great winner for Boskovic. Bosch was creeping a little bit into court and left a little bit too much cross court. You get goosebumps when you see that. All the superlatives have been used up. Skills just to calmly roll that off the block and then keep Corneliano in front. So Sebastian called the timeout. It's coming in. Is Sebastian going to give up without a fight? That's to be expected. Down, unfortunately, Singer looking to try and pretend she got the hand completely under the ball. It's a good serve against Natalia. It's a really good block, and it's such a good serve because Natalia's the front court swing hitter for Zasabashi. She's being pinned deep on her right shoulder, back into court, and then she's trying to get out wide to have the swing. And the block was well set to deal with that. Timeout called by Zasabashi. Corneliano are close to victory. Very close. Thank you. difficult for her, but Kim comes up to rescue the situation for Itsasabashi. Style volleyball on there. Well, that's a good serve. Gertie's in a bit of trouble. De Janeiro. My goodness! Who said that? Who just said that they were in trouble? Was it me? Of course they weren't. Not when Ogonu could do that. What trouble? You just have to respect that. Because that is another level entirely. Sorokate coming in to serve. Corneliano now requiring 3 points. Into this. Brilliant. Just brilliant from Foley. Didn't panic. Walsh with the presence of mind to go to Foley in the middle. They get their side out. Keep turning the screw against Itsasabashi. Thinks it is out. Oh, goodness me, it was nearly all over. I hope you haven't spilled your drinks and your food, those of you supporting Corneliano here, thinking that it was all done. Is it all done? We got a challenge. Motta says it's out. Goodness me, it went straight down, that's for sure. Did it go down and catch any of the line? Ah, Corneliano. World Club champion, Saar Itsasabashi, still in this final. Itsasabashi is still in this final. What a game. You've got to love this sport. And that where challenge actually adds to proceedings, doesn't it? But it's backs to the wall time here for Izasabashi. Natalia with the serve. Kodeliano with three chances to get it done from side out. How many will they need? Just the one. Ikano over the top of the block. The set is taken 25-21. And Kodeliano are the new FIVB Women's World Club champions. They have beaten Izasabashi by 3-1 here in Shaoxing. What a fabulous, fabulous game of volleyball. It has been an amazing week of world-class action here in Shaoxing. And it is Kodeliano who are victorious. Izasabashi were third last year, they're second this year. They actually won it in 2015. But it is the year of Kodeliano, their first World Club Championship, their first time here, and they are going to be leaving China as champions, as gold medalists. It's winner, winner. Pizzeria dinner. Ji Zhonghui, the honorary life president of the FIVB, waiting patiently to present the trophy. He is joined by the mayor of Shaoxing City, Mr. Xing Santorini. Quite understandably over the moon. There is Mr. Shen Ye Chun, the mayor of Shaoxing. Kessler from the FIVB just telling the mayor that they can now come on to court and present the trophy. Connie Kurth getting a few last second shots, and Walsh waiting patiently as well as the trophy now appears. Congratulations, Kodeliano. They are the champions here in Shaoxing. Congratulations to Izasabashi. They played their part in a really good game of volleyball, but in the end it was Kodeliano who were just too good, too strong, too powerful, too quick, too well disciplined. Confirmation of the score, 22-25, 25-14, 19 and 21. Waiting patiently to have a chat with us. We can have a quick look at the stats before that and tell us the tale of the set. Fletcher's just got back from a quick photo opportunity. This is the tale of the match overall. Kodeliano better in block, better in serve. Only made 10 errors. That's brilliant. Really is brilliant. That's what you play for. That's what makes it all worthwhile. These moments, these special moments that will live with you forever and can't be taken away. Another medal to go in the trophy cabinet for these players. It wasn't quite to be for Izasabashi. They have to pick themselves up, dust themselves down, get ready for their domestic season. Let's have
Kimberly Hill, congratulations, world champion. Wow, what a feeling, emotional feeling. Also after this tough battle last night, how you found the energy tonight?
I'm not sure. I think we won this match purely with spirit and with heart and grit. And I'm so proud of this team. We gave everything we had and we came out on top. And I'm so grateful to be on this team with this club.
What will you take back home to Italy from this tournament? Like many good souvenirs? Tired legs, maybe?
Both of those, for sure. Good memories, and also just a confidence that our team can beat anyone, I think, if we play our game. And hopefully we just continue it on for the rest of the season.
Are you a party team? Good luck. Thank you.
Well, they have license to party. They've just won the World Club Championship.
Thank you. First best outside hitter, number 10 from Asia's Foundation. Thank you. Thank you. Four, three, five, four.